will eventually understand that we don't drive for peanuts. So if you want to wait around, I suggest get a bicycle, start walking. If you want to start paying decent rates to drivers, we'll be back on the road. But until then, happy working, walking, Massachusetts.
Massachusetts will be coming alive this Saturday in a way we have not seen in a year and a half.
But if you're counting on an Uber or a Lyft, there's not a chance happening. You could find yourself stranded. Boston 25 News reporter Drew Caritas is live in Boston to explain why there may not be enough rideshare drivers to go around for the state's full reopening. Drew?
Mark, people we've been talking with describe routinely waiting more than 30 minutes for an Uber or a Lyft, sometimes not being able to find a driver at all at night. The rideshare driver shortage is especially being felt here in Massachusetts because of a ban on surge pricing that will not be lifted until more than 2 weeks after the state's reopening.
So if it's past like 7 or maybe 8 o'clock, you're stranded.
It's a predicament Ashley Bazell says she's found herself in more than once.
It says a little blank at the bottom. It says there's no one available.
Nobody. We don't drive for peanuts.
Uber Lyft drivers is creating a safety issue after public transportation shuts down.
Definitely for females like myself walking home at night.
There is just this big practical challenge of if Uber and Lyft are not available. It's a question mark for me.
Sarah Bannon worries more people coming into the city for the first weekend of large events and clubs and bars opening until 2 a.m. may not realize how difficult it is to find a driver to get home.
Eventually, after probably like 5 minutes or so, just nothing comes up.
At Logan Airport's rideshare pickup, arriving passengers also describing nightmare
wait
times.
Same as LAX.
So the driver was about 2 minutes out, and then all of a sudden the wait time just got further and further.
Rideshare drivers we spoke with off camera tell us there are still so few drivers out there because of a Massachusetts law passed after the brutal winter of 2015 forbidding surge pricing during declared emergencies. The current state of emergency won't be lifted until June 15th. Last month, the Baker-Polito administration filed legislation to adjust that law. A spokesperson tells us, quote, "This is now the third time the administration has filed legislation to make this fix, but it has not yet been taken up by the legislature." A spokesperson for Massport tells us Uber and Lyft activity at Logan Airport has been down nearly 80%, and they're anticipating more drivers will return as passenger activity increases. Spokespersons for
Logan.
Uber and Lyft tell us they're seeing a big increase in demand for rides, and they're working to meet that demand by offering incentives to drivers. We're live in Boston's Theater District. Drew Caritas, Boston 25 News.
Hopefully they get more.
So the problem is, look, you can throw a big bait and switch incentives at drivers, but we're not stupid. We've learned from the past that you're conning the drivers, newbies, and they're not going to come. So they've been spending promises of $250 million of bonuses. They're not bonuses. They're poor, pathetic guarantees, and drivers are not taking the bait. Not in Massachusetts, not in Los Angeles, not in Vegas. We've learned our lesson that you cannot trust Uber, period. So, dear riders, I have bad news for you. Get on those feet, get on the bicycle, get on those e-bikes, get on your scooters, get on your skateboards, whatever it takes. But it's going to take a long, long time before drivers get the respect that they deserve, get the pay that they deserve, and that they get stopped with all these bait and switch tactics that Dara has been implementing and Logan has been implementing over the years. So we're not stupid. We've learned from our mistakes. Sadly, the rider is going to pay the price. Now, huge shout out to my sponsor, Curiel, Anything Delivered. Check it out. Download the app below. And when it comes to safety, I highly suggest you go and buy yourself a dash cam or you get Display Ride, nonstop ride share monitoring platform. Have a great day. And do please feel free to share your input. Drive safe.